What's up, everybody? Appliance guy Picker here. Out here doing more appliance repair than picking, though. I have been busy as a dog. But I wanted to do a real quick video about home warranty companies. As you start your appliance repair business, you are going to probably consider at some point, do I want to do work for home warranty companies? And I'll give you my two cents, and this is just my opinion, my experience, what I've been through, but you can decide for yourself. I personally think that the home warranty companies are great to get you started. I will say this, if you really don't have a clue what you're doing, and you're pretty much just going out guessing, not doing any troubleshooting, don't really know diagnosing, you need to get a little more training before you put yourself out there with warranty companies and things like that. Really, you shouldn't even be on your own yet. You should go back and learn a little more, get a little more training. But if you feel pretty confident and you can go into a house and you know how to pre-trip diagnose and you know how to troubleshoot and you know how to read schematics and things of that nature, then the home warranties are something definitely to consider as a part of your business plan. And as you know, or as you should know if you watch my video on business plans, business plans are an evolving piece of literature. They are not a set in stone. Your business plan when you start might completely change a year later. It might completely change 2 years later. It should be changing quite frequently. But part of your business plan might be to get involved with the home warranty companies. I tell you what I did. When I first got started, I signed up with 3 home warranty companies. I started off with 210. Then I added on Cross Country Home Services. And then I added on American Home Shield. So those are 3 of the major players out there. I think I ran 1 call for Choice when I first started, but I didn't like anything about their system and the way they do things. And I don't have anything good to say about them. Don't have anything necessarily bad. It just wasn't a good fit for me. And like I said, my experience is my experience. You might find something completely different. So I got signed up with 3 warranty companies. Each warranty company, in my opinion, had its pros and cons. So it had some things that I liked about it, had some things that I didn't like about it. First one I dropped was 210. I got rid of them fairly early on. The number one problem with them that I had was my customer relations person. She was completely hands-off. Like, she didn't care. She didn't check up. She didn't, you know, just no relationship there. Second one I dropped was Cross Country. I liked Cross Country. My customer service representative was fairly good. She wasn't amazing or anything. She did seem to care. Like, she came to Richmond and met me, and we met at Starbucks or something and talked, and, you know, she's pretty cool. But the reason I stopped using them was because of their portal. Every home warranty company has a portal, and that's where you go to get authorization, submit invoices, keep up with your jobs, and all that stuff. Cross Country Home Services portal was horrible. It was always crashing. It was always having issues and this, that, and the other. So my favorite fit, and the fit that I'm still with today, is American Home Shield. My contractor relations guy is great. I love their portal. They actually have 2 portals. If you sign up with them, you can get a free account, or you used to be able to get a free account with Dispatch Me. So if Dispatch Me is one of the things you want to use for your business anyway, if you do work for American Home Shield, you get a free membership, and you can schedule your calls. You can schedule all your stuff through Dispatch Me. It's a little app. I don't use Dispatch Me, but it's an option. And just their system, just the way they flow. I like American Home Shield. I'm doing a lot of work for them. I'd say at least 50% of my business comes from them. But here's a couple of the pros of working for home warranty companies. Number one is they're sending you work. You don't have to pay them anything. It doesn't cost you anything. They're sending you jobs, and you can go out and, you know, get these jobs while you build your business. It's good filler work while you're getting your CODs and your property managers and your real estate agents and all those things lined up, your other accounts. So home warranties are a good filler for that. Another thing is the home warranties actually want to provide the parts because they get a better deal on the parts. So let's say you're a fairly new business and you don't got a whole ton of money to put into parts. You don't have your truck stock isn't that great yet. You don't have a whole lot of parts. Well, the good thing about American Home Shield is you can order your parts through them. You can go on the portal, tell them you want American Home Shield to provide your parts, and they'll send them to you. And that's with every single home warranty company. Typically, the way I do it, I'm a preferred contractor with American Home Shield. So I have a very high authorization limit. I can go out there and fix stuff up to like $500 or something like that. And not even call in, just it's proved on my best judgment. So when you first get started, you're probably going to have like a $250 auto limit. So the way I did it, or the way I still do it, is any part over $150, I let American Home Shield provide it. Now you may lose a little bit money on your part. You're not going to make money on the part, and whatever. But you can make up for that in your labor. So it's not a big deal. But anything over 150, I let them. So that's a nice little thing you can help you along with your business, is they supply the parts. So that was number two. Number three is you don't have to worry about, when you do American Home Shield work, and not all of them are this way, but American Home Shield is, you don't have to worry at all about dealing with money with the customer. Now, I guess that could be a pro and a con, because with other companies, you always collected a deductible. But now American Home Shield has it where you're just there to give the customer a professional quality repair. No money's exchanged. You can just go there, be nice to the customer, you know, talk them up, wow them with your charisma, and just be there to serve the customer and their needs and make them happy. And that's a really nice thing. I like that about doing American Home Shield. When they first switched over to that, I was like, oh, I don't get my deductible. That's my money coming in. Yada yada yada. Once you get the checks flowing, it's not that big a deal. Those are the three major pluses for me, with American Home Shield. It's steady work. You don't always have to supply the part, and, you don't have to deal with the money end of it. American Home Shield is the one that's paying. There's other perks to it. You get your own contractor relations person, and mine with American Home Shield, he's good. He's came out several times and came to my house and met me and talked to me, and he seems to really care about his job and the customers, so that's good. And then lastly on the pros is when you're dealing with American Home Shield, you always have the option to transfer work orders. So let's say you get a call on something and, you know, it's a Sub-Zero fridge and you don't work on Sub-Zero fridges. Well, you can transfer. You don't even have to go out to it. If you go out, you get a service call. But I don't really want to go out on that stuff, so I'll transfer it before. I don't even want to waste my time with it. I'm out here to fix appliances, not collect service calls. If you're a service call collector, let me see what this does. If your game plan is to be out here collecting service calls, then you're not an appliance repair person. So when you get those calls, hey, say it's a Sub-Zero fridge and you don't work on Sub-Zero fridges, then transfer it. I don't work on high-end appliances. That's one thing that I'm changing my business plan. I'm going to get into high-end appliances. I'm going to learn the Sub-Zeros. I'm going to learn the Vikings. I'm going to learn the Wolfs. I'm going to learn the Thermidors. I'm going to learn the Bosch dishwashers. I don't know if they're considered high-end appliances, but I don't work on them, so I want to learn them. So, yeah, there's that. You can always transfer a work order. Or let's say you go out to the house, you do some diagnostics, and you find out it's a sealed system issue, and you don't do sealed system work. Well, guess what? You can transfer the work order. Or let's say you go out to the house, and you realize that it's a plumbing issue. Guess what? You can transfer the work order. So, yeah, that's a nice little feature. And once you've been out to the house, and you, if it's something you diagnose and it ends up being a plumbing issue, you still get time. You still get paid for your time there. You still get your either your $75 service call, or if there's extra diagnostics because you had to do a bunch of stuff to figure out what the problem was, you can get a little more. So that's a nice feature. So a couple of the cons. Can't talk about pros without cons. Number one is you gotta wait for your money. Now, like I said before, you used to collect deductibles with American Homeshield, and I think you do still do with Cross Country and some of the other ones. But with American Homeshield, you do not collect deductibles, at least not in my area. You might in others, because they still ask me all the time if I collected a deductible. But the money, once you get it rolling in, is not a big deal. And if you're doing it for a company where you are collecting deductibles, you're still picking up $50, $75, $100, $125 checks all day. So that's nice. Kind of keeps you going. And then you bill out for your parts and your whatever extra above and beyond what your deductible was. So the money is probably a con as far as having to wait for it. But once you get that money flowing and you're getting, you know, $2,000, $3,000, $4,000 checks every week or so, it's nice. And I get $3,000 to $5,000 checks all the time from American Home Shield. I love it. It's like a major payday for me. But yeah, you can get those checks flowing. So I guess it is and isn't a con. Con number two is you're going to have to deal with some people that you may or may, and this is true with any work, even outside of American Home Show. But with American Home Show, you're going to deal with a lot of walks of life, because people have American Home Shield for their rental properties. People have American Home Shields for their personal properties. You're going to have to deal with lots of different landlords and tenant situations and all that stuff. And you may have to deal with some pretty gross stuff. If something is too gross, though, I will say this. If something's too gross, get it transferred. I went into this one dude's house, and it was just disgusting. I mean, there was crap everywhere. There was just, the stove was just gross, cockroaches. And I looked at the dude and I said, what did I say? I said, sir, I said, I appreciate you letting me in and your time and everything. I said, but I'm going to have to get this work, this transferred. He's like, oh, why? I was like, well, the working conditions are just not up to my standard. It's not, I'm not working in that filth. I'm sorry. So you will come across that and transfer it. Don't go in there. Don't be taking them cockroaches home on your feet, bringing them in your house. So yeah, there's that. And another con that there's really not that many cons, to be honest with you. I'm a big supporter of the home warranty companies. If you can find one that works for you. Let me think of another con. I should have wrote something down. I've been writing stuff down, but I didn't do one for this one. Another con. Ooh, I got one. Another con is you are going to be going behind other contractors. You're going to be going behind other appliance repair technicians. These guys are not appliance repair technicians. They're freaking jacklegs. And you will know it. You will see their work. You will go out and you will look at the appliance. You'll be like, what? What were they doing? I went out on one the other day. It was a LP range. And the orifice in the burner, you know, the burner orifice, was set to natural gas. So that thing was wide open, blowing out big orange flames. Another guy came before me. He didn't know how to fix it. He didn't know how to adjust a burner orifice on a gas range from propane to from natural gas to propane. So I'm just thinking to myself, they got this guy running service calls. So of course I go out there and fix it. And took me 3.5 minutes to turn that orifice down. Got her burner burning pretty. Got her happy. She loves me. I won't say the name of the other company, but my name is The Appliance Guy. TK, The Appliance Guy. Not to be confused with any other. So that's a con. You know, you're going to go behind some jacklegs. There's a couple companies. Sears is one of them. I'll say Sears' name. I don't care. You suck, Sears. Sears, you suck. Everything about you sucks. And I'm saying it. Everything about Sears sucks. Their service sucks. Their parts department sucks. I tried to set up an account with Sears. I'm getting off on a tangent. I got ADD. I tried to set up a parts account. Pro parts account with Sears. They couldn't even do that right. So yeah, forget Sears. They suck. Then a couple other guys I go behind them. But and you know, while I say that's a con, it's also a pro, because you always gotta look at the positive with everything. When you're the one going behind these jacklegs, when they see, oh look, Joe Schmo appliance went out on this one, they messed it up. The appliance guy came after him, fixed it. That if that cycle keeps happening and happening, guess who's flashing red radar on their screen? The other guy. Guess who's flashing green positivity of love on their screen? You are, because you're the one out there fixing the stuff that Jack Low Joe messed up. So that's a pro and a con too. I always look at the positive and the negative. I feel like anything, there's a positive and a negative. That's how life is. We got positives, and that with that positive, there's some negative. It's like electricity. You got your negatives and your positives. I'm like Biggie Smalls. I went from negative to positive, and it's all good. Y'all don't know nothing about Biggie Smalls. He's the illest. So, y'all are like, this freaking white boy's crazy. Eat out day. Went to Arby's, got me a roast beef. So, yeah, go out there. Test out some of these home warranty companies. Worst thing that can happen is it doesn't work out. You don't like them. They don't like you, whatever. And you go and you do something else. But I like American Home Shield. Cross Country Home Services was a good company. 210 seemed to be a pretty good company, too. I'm not bashing any of them. If you have other experiences with home warranty companies, by all means, please leave your comments in the comment section. If you have had a bad experience with them, feel free to share that, too. Maybe you hate American Home Shield and you love Choice Home Warranty. Just let us know, because the guys that are going to be watching these things just want to get more information. There is quite a bit of paperwork when you're signing up. I remember filling out all the paperwork for these companies, and my wife had to help me because I'm not a paperwork kind of guy. And I was like, what does this mean? What is this? What is this? I'm a go out there and do it kind of guy. I don't do well with paperwork. But I got a system for my paperwork. That's what it's all about, systems. So yeah, I'm all done, man. I'm just pulled in my driveway. I'm about to go in here and bill out some invoices, order some parts, and get ready for tomorrow. Tomorrow's Friday. Thank God it's Friday. So yeah, check out the home warranties. Go to their websites. Know your market. Know about these things. This is part of your industry. If you're in the appliance repair industry and you have no idea about home warranties, you don't know your industry. Learn the industry. Learn the ins and outs. Learn the different things that are going on. But I'm trying to think if I forgot anything about home warranties. So the main thing is volume of work. I can set my volume. I have it set right now where American Home Shield sends me 4 calls a day. And being a preferred contractor, which it took me a year or so, to get that. But now that I'm a preferred contractor, I'm first on the list. That means me and the other preferred contractors in my area, we get the first picks of the job. Not that we get to pick them, but they send them to us first. And then the people that aren't preferred contractors, they get the leftovers. So I'm guaranteed 4 calls a day. If 4 calls come in that day, guess who's getting some of them? TK, the appliance guy. So yeah, But check out the home warranties. I don't know enough about factory warranty to talk about it because I don't do any. I'm looking into that now and thinking about looking into... I hear that their pay sucks, but I heard that home warranty pay sucks. I make exact same money on home warranty jobs as I do my regular jobs. So yeah, so just check it out. Immerse yourself, as I've said before, immerse yourself in the appliance repair industry.